Good morning. Happy Thanksgiving. Thanks for watching the channel and everything. For everybody that doesn't live outside the United States, I'm sorry you guys are missing this. We're going to end up killing a lot of turkeys today. But hey, I appreciate you guys all watching the channel and everything. Obviously, we've progressed from where it was to where, well, it's not really progressed anywhere. You're just kind of stuck watching me do absolutely nothing. The contest will be coming up pretty soon, so look for the announcement on that. I would suggest, if you're not a subscriber, to go down below, hit the subscribe button, and subscribe to the channel. It will make it a lot easier to win on the contest, or I don't know how you call it a contest. Your name's just going to get drawn out of a bucket. But either way, I would suggest you subscribe, and that's kind of one of the tricks and I'm going to use to determine a winner and everything like that. You'll see in an upcoming video, and if you're not watching it, you're not subscribed, you might miss it. So subscribe down below. So speaking of turkeys, I actually have a great YouTube channel coming up. And I don't have the iPad out here or anything like that to help me out or cue me on this. I'm just kind of doing this ad hoc before we get ready to head on out. I believe his name is N.S. Modler. You probably know who he is. You've seen him. So somewhere there's going to be a splash screen and all that kind of good jazz, which is probably not going to happen today. We'll skip that. We'll do that at another time. Sorry, NS Modeler, I'll have to get everything correct. You know, basically, you just got turkeyed out. So, thanks again for watching. Stick around, I do have a quick video clip on installing DCC decoders into a Fox Valley model, the GP60. So, we can watch that really quick. Well, let's see about installing a decoder. I have the shell off of 327, and decoder should be pretty easy to install on these. So we'll just end up taking the old decoder out, give a little tug, and I might end up being in the way of the camera, but it should just slide right out like that. And it's labeled. I don't know if you can see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Important thing to know is where pin 1 is. As you can see at the moment, I have my shell off my GP60B unit. Some weirdness has come up, and this might be a little bit odd. On this little plug right here that I took off, as you can see on the camera, it's labeled 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So which would mean this far, and it was plugged in here just like this. This far pin would be pin 1. And according to the manual on the DZ125IN, that this, if we flip it over here, is pin 1. I don't know how well you can see it, but this would be pin 1. The only problem is, we'll look at the picture again here in the manual, is that will not fit into that socket in that orientation. It's just not going to happen. It's the components hit the top of the board and everything in it. It's just not made to fit that way. But if you go to the very last page of the manual for the DZ125IN, it shows, and
hopefully you can see it. The same setup here for the Fox Valley N scale, that it is flipped over, as I'll flip that over here, as such, with the solder bumps on the top of the unit plugging to the underside of that board. So not sure whether Fox Valley messed up with this numbering scheme here, because if it should be, is I'm not gonna flip it over, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, they got it backwards according to the manual. DigiTrax has a 1-year warranty, no oops. The only way this decoder will fit in this orientation anyway, so that's why I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna try it in that orientation, hopefully it works. If not, we'll find out. It won't fit in the other direction. So this little number board here, the plug is not numbered right, is what I'm guessing, or it just doesn't fit in the other direction, because it's got this little resistor on the top, so they just decided to plug it in this way. To be honest, and I'm trying to see if I can spot anything, most chips and everything will label a 1 or put a dot or something that orientate where 1 is. They didn't do this. That's kind of a standard practice. I'm trying to look at the connector, see if I can spot anything that might indicate where 1 is. I don't see anything. So I'm just going to go with the fact the way it fits in there, because it won't fit any other way, and kind of matching the picture that is in the manual, which shows that, as I'll show you a picture one more time here, it shows the board, the square chip is on the top, the solder bumps are on the top. So that's why I'm going to mount it in here. It's the only way it will actually fit. And DigiTrax claims warranty, 1-year, no worries warranty, blah, 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 blah. So I'm going with it. And pretty much all these boards are just a slip in, because I'm going to have to lift it up because I can't see very well to do it on camera. So I'll just push it in, and that's as long as it takes. That was pretty easy installation. Once you orientate that decoder in the right direction, or what I perceive to be the right direction based on the information that's given me. It won't fit any other way. We can do a little check really quick. Obviously it doesn't start out in dual mode. Let's see if it says it in the manual. Alright, I did this a little bit off camera. Installation is really quick and easy. As you can see, unlike the picture that is provided in the manual, as you can see, it's got the big square IC on the top, the solder bumps on the top side of it. Well, it doesn't actually go in that way. It's actually flipped over. So pin 1, as per the plug, is in the right spot. It's a sloppy setup. So the way it's shaped, the pins, solder, and then the components are actually banged up against the bottom of the PC board on the top side. I think it's sloppy the way it's set up. Literally, I think it should have been flipped like we discussed earlier in the video. That's the way it goes on. I just checked it out, programmed it. It works just fine. So that's something to keep your eye out for. And it is a dual mode decoder in it. Works really well. So we'll do this decoder change really quick one more time. We'll see how much I can get it done on camera. It's pretty simple. Just grab that little plug, pull the plug out as such, grab your new decoder. And I hopefully can do this on camera, but I can't really see it that well. Yeah, I can't see it that well. I'll just do it off camera really quick. But all it is just getting the pins lined up. Give it a quick push. Had they line up the pins off camera, but that's the decoder install. That's for the Digitrax DZ125IN decoder. Just remember that the pins are labeled 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 when you take them off. Pin 1 is the right way. The picture is kind of backwards in the manual as we looked at. Even though the decoder should, I don't know why it's that way, but it would work better upside down. But there we go. All that's left now is to put the cabs or the covers back on the shells. I'll do that in just a couple seconds and we'll continue on with the video. We're gonna watch our trio of Jeep 60s leave LaGrange, screaming like a bunch of howler monkeys, but we did have a successful decoder install on all three units. They're Fox Valley models, and I think I'm gonna contact them about the motor noise. They're fine models, except for the noise.
All right, well, that's it. That's all I got. All I can say now is do not forget to reach down below and subscribe. Don't forget, you know, I got other videos coming out. Some of them are more exciting than others. Some of the op session videos can be really entertaining for some and really boring for others. So if you don't want to watch them, don't watch them. It doesn't hurt. Either way, you can do the old give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down. It doesn't matter. But you know how it works. So happy Thanksgiving. 'At least we got the right sound going on. It's not like Christmas already for the past month and a half. Hey, talk to you guys later and look forward to future videos. And I will be back with you, I'm saying really soon, but probably in a couple days. Thanks for watching.